Hello students, in our today's class, let us study about 4th standard maths, chapter multiplication, exercise 5.3. Multiply these 31 into 4. So how to solve this problem? So the problem is 31 into 4. So, first what you have to do is 4 you have to multiply by 1 and write the answer. Then 4 multiply by 3, write the answer. So, let us begin. 4 into 1. So, 4 ones are 4. 4 threes are, yes, 12. So, the answer is 124. Okay, see the next one. 50 into 3. So, 50 into 3. So, first 3 multiplied by 0, then 3 multiplied by 5. 3 into 0 is 0. Always remember one thing, whenever you multiply any number by 0, the answer is always 0. So 3, 5 is a 15. So the answer is 150. Let us study the next one. 210 into 40. So here you see the two numbers. Always start from this side, that is unit place. The number is in unit place, then you have to move to the number in the tens place. So first you multiply by 0. So 0 zeros are 0, 0 ones are 0, 0 twos are 0. Then 4 you have to multiply by 4. Okay, 4 zeros are 0. Here you have to leave one space. As you have studied in your last class, here you have to leave one space. So 4 ones are 4. 4 twos are 8. And write the numbers. It is 0, 0, 4, 8. So the answer is 8,400. 8,400. Now see this one, 52 into 22. Okay, here also there are two numbers. I told you just now, we have to begin with the unit place. So, first you multiply by 2. 2 twos are 4. 2 fives are 10. Here leave one place. So 2 twos are 4, 2 fives are 10. Here 4, 0 plus 4, 4, 1 plus 0, 1, 1 as it is. So answer is 1144. 1144. Here there are two problems left, so you have to solve this problem by yourself. Now let us move on to the next Roman number. Solve these problems. The cost of 1 meter cloth is rupees 32. What is the cost of 4 meter cloth? So the cost of 1 meter cloth they have already given here. It is 32. That is for 1 meter. Now we have to find out the cost for 4 meter cloth. Okay. So let us start solving this problem. So first you have to write cost of 1 meter cloth. That is equal to rupees 32. Right. So therefore, cost of, you have to find out the cost of 4 meter cloth. So therefore cost of 4 meter cloth is equal to, you have to find out here. So how to find out the answer? You have to just multiply 32 by 4. So 4 2's are 8, 4 3's are 12. So the answer is 128. That is rupees 128. So the cost of 4 meter cloth is rupees 128. So see the second problem. 1 kilogram of rice cost rupees 40. What is the cost of 5 kilogram of rice? So they have given. So 1 kg of rice, it is rupees 40. So 1 kg of rice if you buy, the cost is 40 rupees. So what is the cost if you buy 4 kg of rice? So let us start solving this problem. So cost of 1 kg rice, that is rupees 40. Therefore cost of how much? 5 kg rice is equal to, you have to find out the answer. To find the answer, you have to multiply 40 by 5. So 5 zeros are 0. If you multiply any number by 0, the answer is always 0. So 4 5s are 20. So the answer is rupees 200. Rupees 200 is the cost of 5 kg of rice. See the next problem. A cinema hall has 32 rows and each row has 42 seats. Find the number of seats in the cinema hall. So there are 32 rows and in each row there are 42 seats. So you have to find out the total number of seats in the cinema hall. So what you have to do? You have to just multiply 32 by 42 and you will get the answer. Okay, let us see the last problem here. Somanna manufactures 122 bricks in a day. So 122 bricks in a day. And is enough in his factory. How many bricks can he make in 24 days? So one day he can manufacture 122 bricks. So 24 days he can manufacture. How to find out the answer? You have to multiply 122 by 24. So these two problems you have to solve by yourself. Now let us move on to the next exercise in the chapter multiplication. Exercise 5.4. Multiply the following. You see here, 75 is multiplied by 8. 75 is multiplied by 8. Okay. 75 is multiplied by 8. Here we are learning multiplication with carrying. You are carrying a value and it is multiplication by carrying. So similar to the previous one, we have to solve this problem also. So 8 you have to multiply first by 5 then by 7. So 8 5s are 40. So 40, correct? 8 5s are 40. So in 40, 0 is in unit place, 4 is in tens place. So whatever is in unit place you have to write here as you do in the process of addition. Same thing you are doing here. Then this 4 you are carrying here. Okay, you are carrying here. So 8 7s are how much? So 8 7s are, it is 56, correct? 56. So here you are carried 4. So you have to add 4 to it. You will get 60 as the answer. That 60 you are writing here. So 75, when you multiply by 8, the answer is 600. This is multiplication with carrying. With carrying. Let us study the second one. 627 multiplied by 7. So it is 627 multiplied by 7. So we'll start multiplying 7 by 7 first, then 2, then 6. So 7 7s are, what's the answer? 7 7s are 49. So 9 here, 4 you are carrying here. Okay, now 7 twos are 14, and you have to add, it is 14, you have to add 4 to it because you have carried 4. So 4, 4 is 8 when you add, and it is 1. So 18. So here it is 18. 8 is in unit place, you have to write here. Again you have to carry this 1 here. Clear? Clear. So next 7, 6 are 7, 6 are 42. You have carried 1 here, it is 43. So when you multiply 627 by 7, the answer is 4389. Let us solve this problem now. It is 83 multiplied by 26. 83 multiplied by 26. So here there are two numbers. I told you in the beginning, whenever there are two numbers, you have to start with a number in the unit place. So first you have to multiply by 6. 6 3 is 18. 6 3 is 18. So 8 you are writing here, 1 you are carried here, right? So 6 8 is 48, and your 1 carried here. 48 plus 1 is 49. Right, now you are multiplying with 2. This one is not required now. Yes, 2 3 is a 6. Don't write 6 here, you have to write here. Here you have to leave one space. So 6. 2 8 is a, it is 16. So 16. Clear? So start adding. 8. 9 plus 6 is 15. 1 here. So 1 plus 4 is 5. 5 plus 6 is 11. 1 here. 1 plus 1 is 2. So the answer is 2158. Answer is here 2158. So 3 problems are left up. That is for you to solve by yourself. Now let us move on to the next Roman number. Solve the following problems. First one, a school boy saves rupees 25 every month. How much does he save in 1 year? So one school boy, he saves rupees 25 every month. How much does he save in 1 year? So 1 month he is saving 25 rupees. So in 1 year, how much amount will he save? You have to find out. So 1 year has how many months? 12 months. So you have to find out savings in 12 months. So first you have to write savings in 1 month. So it is 25, rupees 25. Now savings in 1 year. So 1 year is nothing but 12 months. So savings in 12 months. Here you can write 1 year also. So it is, you have to multiply 25 by 12. Same way, starting from here, 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 4 and 1 5, leave one space, 1 5s are 5, 1 2s are 2. The answer is 0. 5 plus 5 is 10, that is 2 plus 1 is 3. So rupees 300, rupees 300. Okay, second problem. There are 75 chocolates in a packet. How many chocolates are there in 7 such packets? So one packet has 75 chocolates. So you have to find out how many chocolates are there in 7 packets. So first you have to write chocolates in 1 pack. So it is 75. Therefore, chocolates in 7 packs. It is, you multiply 75 by 7. 7 5s are 35. 3 here. 7 7s are 49, 49 plus 3, it is 50, 51, 50, 2. Answer is 525. Similarly, you see here such 4 problems. They are very easy, so you have to solve by yourself.